Hello and welcome to this video of the course Answers at Solving in Practice, where we are going to do the part 1D of the exercise on simple solving of the computational aspects part of the course. Here we have the program P, and I have copied it here once and twice. And I've copied it twice because we are going to be doing the redact with respect to a lower bound and to an upper bound. So let's start with it. And first we have here the lower bound, the empty set. And for the upper bound, I'm going to write here the set of all the atoms occurring in the program. That is A, C, R, M, F, W. And then this will be easier this way. So here we have L prime, and here we have to put the consequences of the P reduced by L prime. So let's do here the redact with respect to this L prime. So given that we have the empty set, all this goes away, and then we get the A from here, C, R. We have the C, we get the M here. Here we have the R, okay, we get the M also from this other way. With the A, we get the F. And with the F, the W, and here we could also get the A again, but we already have it. So basically, this gives us all the atoms. So we get it here, and we do the intersection of these two, and we get all the atoms. So intuitively, what this is telling us is that any stable model that is a superset of the empty set has to be a subset of this one. And actually, this doesn't give us any new information because we already knew that every stable model has to be a subset of the set that contains all the atoms. And now, if we go with this to get the consequences of the redact of P with respect to U, here in this case, given that we have all the atoms, we get rid of all rules with some negative literal, and now all the rules have some element in the body, then the empty set is the set of consequences of this program, and we have it here, and then the union, this we have it like this, the union is the empty set. Okay, so then what this shows is that doing this, applying this expand procedure here, we do not get any new information. Hence, we have to make a choice. And given that we have here the C, let's make the choice on C. And first, let's try to make C true. And then let's see what happens when C is false. Then for this, let's clean this. Oops, sorry for that. And on the other side, same story. Okay, good. Then here, if C is true, then the lower bound contains the atom C, and here in the upper bound, still everything is possible. And on this other side here, if C is false, then what's going to happen is that we are going to have here A minus C. Okay, and I'm going to write it completely. So this is A, R, M, F, W. Okay, so here we have the set of all atoms, and we have to get the consequences of P reduced by the set of atoms, and this we already had it here, that was the empty set. So we have here the empty set, and when we do the union, we get the C here. While now from this L prime, we have to get the consequences from, yes. And then here, then if we can, if we are going to do here the redact, then this rule disappears, and this becomes simplified. So we get the C from here, the R, with the C we get the M, and then nothing else happens, right? Because from here we could get the M, but we already have it, and then we do not have the M or the F here, or the F here, or the W here either. So then the consequences are C, R, and M, and the intersection is C, R, and M. Then intuitively what this says is that any stable model that is a superset of this must be a subset of this. So, and I put it another way, any stable model that contains the C does not contain the A, the F, and the W. And this makes sense because if you have the C, let's now come to the logic program and see it. If we have the C, then we cannot have the A here. Hence, A has to be false because there's no rule that can give this to us. And then if A is false, then we don't get the F from here, so there's no other rule for F, so then F has to be false, and then if F is false, there's no way to get the W there, right? So then it makes sense that if C is true, then only these atoms are possible. Good, then now we get C here, and we get C, R, and M on this other side. Now with C, we have to get here this one, and this is exactly the same that we were doing before. So we know, again, here we have C, R, M, and here we get C, R, M also. Like these are intersections, and these are unions. Okay, and now here we have to do the reader with respect to this C, R, M, and we come here with C, R, M, we get rid of this. Oh, no, sorry, with C, we get rid of the rule because we have the C and we do not have the A, we do not have the value, the W, right? We are looking at this one. And now if we look, the redact that we have down here is the same that we had there, right? And if here we have seen that we have CRM, then basically this is CRM, also the consequences because it's the same problem, right? Then we get here CRM. And we do the union and we get C, R, M here. And then the next steps are straightforward because we have already made the calculation. So if we have all this here, we already know what are the consequences with respect to C, R, M that we should put here and here because we have already computed them in this case, right? So it's C, R, M. Again, we have, so here we have done the redact with respect to CRM, and these are the consequences, CRM. So then we can add here, CRM, and then the union, CRM. And similarly, with this, we go to here with the consequences. So when I say I go to here, it means that here I will put the consequences of the program reduced by this. And these are CRM. And then I get C, R, M here. Then at this point, I have that these two sets are equal and that these two sets are also equal. So then the expand procedure stops. And given that L is equal to U, we know that this L and U represent the stable model of the program. And this is C, R, M. And I can write it here, SM of P contains this C, R, M. Good, so now let's go to the other branch where C is false. And then with this, we come to here, and this is the same as what we were doing before. So we have this again, and here when we do the intersection, we have I, R, M, F, W. And now we have to do the redact with respect to this and put here the consequences. So let me erase this here. And continue. So now we have that A is true, W is true, and C is false. So A is true, W is true, so this goes away. C is false, then we stay like that. And with this, we can derive the A from here. With the A, we have the F here. With the F, we have the W. And now here with F and W, we could get the A, but we already have it. and we do not have the R or the C, so we cannot fire these other rules. So hence, the consequences are A, F, W. I write them here, and here comes the union A, F, W. Good. So then again, intuitively, what this means is that every stable model that is a subset of this, so every stable model where C is false, is a superset of this. So every stable model where C is false, A, F, and W are true. And this, if we look here at the logic program, if C is false, A must be true, and then F must be true, and W must be true. Good. Then we continue, and here we have A, F, W, and here we have all these A, R, M, F, W. Now, what we have to put here is exactly what we have done before. So we can just copy this, and here we write the union A, F, W. And now here we have to look for the consequences of this, of A, F, W. And let's get them, let's do this reduct here. And okay, AFW, now with the F, this goes away, C is false. And now basically we see that this program, the program that we have now, is exactly the same that we had before. And before we have that the consequences are AFW, so we know the consequences now of this program are also AFW. And here we get the intersection. Now again, intuitively, what this is telling us is that every stable model that is a superset of this is a subset of this. So that whenever A, F, and W are true, then the other atoms not here, that are, let me see there, C, R, and M are false, right? Because if basically, if well, let's look at this. So if A is true, we cannot derive the C from here, so C must be false. If W is true, we cannot derive the R from here, and R is false. So now we know R and C are false. And then the M needs either C or R, but if both are false, we cannot derive it, right? So this is looking at the program, how we can also see that if we have A, F, and W, then we do not have C, R, and M. So these are all the possible ones, right? And now we just continue A, F, W, and A, F, W here. And we have already computed the reduct, the consequences of the reduct with respect to the set, because we have them there. Hence, we copy it here and here, right? These are, from here we go to there, and from here we come to this place. And now we get back to the set A, F, W. And basically, here it happens like before, that now this L prime equals L, U prime equals U, and furthermore, the L is the same as the U, and hence we know that this is a stable model. And then we can come to here and say that this is the other stable model, and this finishes the exercise. Good. So this was all. I hope you have enjoyed it and you understood it. So see you in another video. Ciao.